Indeed, and to you and the listeners.
Now, what can you tell us about Mum Mbeki, and what are some of the fondest memories that you have of her?
Well, I haven't had a very long personal interaction with her. I'd like to start off by simply saying that this is an individual who, throughout her life, had unwavering commitment to the freedom and upliftment of the people of our country, I would say across the color lines. But I think a distinguishing feature, something which we have learned from her now, is that there was for her no rest. There could not have been for her comfort without the comfort of the people of South Africa, particularly the peasantry and the workers of our country.
Now, we understand that she also joined COPE as a member a few years back. Now, how can you describe her contribution to the party?
My sense is that she was able to discern timelessly that the achievement of political democratic freedom that did not merge with or combine with economic upliftment of the people of our country would have been less than what was required. Essentially, therefore, that she could not rest and she could not enjoy the limited fruits that sections of the population, of the black population of our country enjoy or could access, were not for her unless it was for the rest of the poor, the uneducated, the backward elements left behind by years of discrimination. And therefore, that she was amongst the leading figures who suggested that it was correct that we should not settle down and be comfortable in the present when there was this outstanding mission. And I think by joining on with the effort in opposition to what we saw at that time as corruption, as negligence of the poor and the unfortunate, motivated her to become part of the effort to set up the Congress of the People. I think that she refused to suffer from the fatigue of struggle for justice for all, especially economic upliftment of all the people of our country. That, I think, is a distinguishing feature of this comrade.
In the few moments that you've also spent with her and interacted with her and also studied her life and have known of her, what would you say are some of the key contributions that she's had on your life? How has she impacted you personally as Musiwa Lekota?
From my person, this essential element I just touched on, here was somebody who was comfortable in what she could give, not demanding for herself, what she could contribute to others. In a sense, I understood her to mean that the essential thing about life is not conquering, but living well. Sometimes, in the short, limited period when we spoke, she referred to the importance of the lives of those who had founded the liberation movement, had lived the cultivation of that idea, but never saw the day of freedom. And yet their lives remained as fulfilled as the life of those of us who had seen Freedom Day. Giving and always giving to the people, but not demanding for the self. That is what I understood.
And just before we let you go, Mr. Lekota, your message to the Mbeki family, your message to South Africans, as the whole nation mourns, of course, this great struggle hero.
Now, I'd like to say to the Mbeki family, extended family, the Zizis, the Pukas, because both on the on Mrs. Mbeki's side and on Mr. Mbeki's side, we are shattered by such a sudden departure of someone who has been an essentially a permanent feature of our childhood, our youth, our activist lives, our adult years, all of this. We are really shattered. We had always come to believe that she'd always be there, whenever we wanted, in those few moments, we could always go up to her and, you know, imbibe some inspiration. Now, that is gone for us. And I'd like to say to them that we are together in this. It's not their loss. It's the loss of all of us. It's the loss of the people of our country. Indeed, it's the loss of the people of the continent of Africa and of the world.
Co-President, Mr. Masuwa Lukota, thank you so much for your time.
Thank you.